If we take sound, turn it into something else that's not sound, then we can store it for later or transmit it across great distances. Now, none of this should be too surprising, but it's kind of amazing when we think about it. We can take sound, a vibration in the air, and turn it into a representation that makes that portable. This is so commonplace in the 21st century that we barely even think about it. But it's worth considering that for much of human history, this wasn't the case. If you wanted to listen to some music, you had to be in the same room as a performance. If you wanted to listen to a speech, you had to be present at that speech. Now, likely for most people, the most common way to listen to music is through a representation of that sound. The composer R. Murray Schafer coined the term schizophonia to describe the separation of a sound from its source, drawing on the Greek prefix schizo, meaning split or separated, and phone, meaning voice. He writes, "Since the invention of electronic equipment for the transmission and storage of sound, any natural sound, no matter how tiny, can be blown up and shot around the world or packaged on tape or record for the generations of the future. We've split the sound from the makers of sound. This dissociation I call schizophrenia." So let's talk a little bit about this conversion of sound into representations of sound, and the considerations that go into the choices we make when recording. The first thing that we do is we take acoustic energy and we convert it into electrical energy, into voltage. We can do this with microphones. Different microphones do this conversion in different ways, but they're all serving as electroacoustic transducers. A transducer is something that changes one kind of energy into another. And an electroacoustic transducer is changing acoustic energy into electrical energy, or vice versa. Now, the microphone is taking the acoustic energy, the vibration in the physical medium, and converting it into electrical energy. And if we think about vice versa, that's something that's going to take electrical energy and turn it into acoustic energy. So these are our loudspeakers. Now, loudspeakers might be in your headphones, inside of your laptop, standalone monitors that you have in your desk, but these are all serving the purpose of taking those changes in voltage and converting them back into acoustic energy. So in an environment, air molecules are vibrating, the microphone takes those high and low pressure fluctuations and converts them into analogous fluctuations in voltage. So when the air pressure gets high, the voltage gets high, and when the air pressure gets low, the voltage gets low. Since these changes in voltage are analogous to fluctuations in air pressure, we call this electrical signal an analog signal. Analog signals, these changes in voltage, can then be sent through wires that conduct electricity, and then a loudspeaker at the other end can convert these changes in voltage back to changes in acoustic energy, back into vibrations in the environment. Or you could take those changes in voltage and record them onto some kind of analog media. You could use them to cut grooves in a record. You could record these different voltages onto magnetic tape. You'll just need a way to convert them back into voltage from that analog media. You could also take those changes in voltage and change them into digital information. But that's going to require another step. That's going to require an ADC, an analog to digital converter. I'm going to dig more into the nitty-gritty of this later on, but in order to store or transmit through any digital device, we need to convert these voltages, these analog signals, into a series of ones and zeros, a series of numbers, data. So, even if you have one of those USB microphones, the Blue Yeti or something like that, it's first converting that sound into voltage, and then converting that voltage into digital information that it passes through the USB. Again, even if you have Bluetooth headphones, there's a digital transmission of sound wirelessly to your headphones, but that needs to be decoded and converted into voltages to vibrate the speakers in the headphones. Now, in all steps of this process, we're thinking about fidelity, faithfulness to the original sound, the original vibration that's happening in the air. If we want high fidelity, we want the electroacoustic transducer of the microphone to convert to fluctuations in voltage as close to that vibration as possible. Then, if we're converting to digital, we want to convert to digital in a way that's as representative of that signal as possible. when we convert back to voltage with our DAC, digital to analog converter, we want that to be as representative as possible. And finally, we want loudspeakers that'll convert that analog representation back into vibrations as closely as possible. Now, if you want to make music that's lo-fi or use effects in various ways, maybe this fidelity isn't as important to you. But either way, it's worthwhile to understand the process in order to achieve the effects that you want.